Hello, Harvard families. It's Corey Tafoya, the district superintendent. I hope to clarify a few things on the letter that was sent regarding our return to school in the fall. First of all, I want to thank all of our families for all the support as we've navigated all of the guidance changes and things that have changed with pandemic and governor's orders. And I just want to clarify a few things to hopefully make it simple. But please do understand we are grateful for all of your support of our students and of the school district as we sort out this maze that is returning to school. But the most important thing we're excited about is that our students will all be back in person, and that's something that we're certainly celebrating from our end. As nearly everyone knows by now, on Wednesday, Governor Pritzker ordered a mask mandate for all pre-K through 12 schools. That's for staff and for students. So now, for our start of the year, it's very simple. We'll follow the governor's mandate that everyone will be within masks within the time they're in school. Now, that does not include outside events, so outside PE and athletics, and things that do happen outside would not require a mask. So much of our discussion these days is about masking, but we also want to assure you that all of the preventative measures to keep our students safe that were in place in the spring are still in place, plus we have a few more. On our website, there's the presentation that I made to the school board regarding all the safety measures and our plan to be back in the fall, but I just want to read to you the number of things that we still have in place to keep our students safe. We encourage vaccinations. That's a really important part of everyone's safety plan. We'll have shield testing, which is a saliva-based system that I can explain to you a little bit later. We'll do a lot of ventilation monitoring of our systems. We have all of our personal routines for the classroom hygiene, the hand washing, and things like that. We'll continue to do all the contact tracings for positive cases that materialize. We have air classroom purifiers that will be in place in every district room as soon as those arrive. We obviously will keep our, at a minimum, 3 feet of social distancing in all learning spaces. We'll be with our masking. We have a really robust cleaning system of door handles, all those things that are part of that. That all continues to be the same. We also want to encourage families, the most important thing is if you are ill in any way, to not send your child. We will do that screening of students, asking you to at least remember those screening questions to think about every day before sending your child to work or for our staff before they come to work. And finally, making sure that there's just a lot of common sense with all the things that are layered in place to keep us safe or observed. But we have a chart that we think will be helpful once local control is restored and the governor's mandate expires, where the school then has some decision and the district will decide how we feel masks should be handled, because we anticipate, as the guidance has changed even just this week, that that will fluctuate throughout the year. And so we've created this chart, which you can also find on our website, that'll help families understand where we are with masking each time. So the red category is what we'll start the school in, where masks are required for all. And then we'll move down to yellow, perhaps, when conditions improve and we have data that things are a little safer locally, where masks are strongly recommended. We still think that's a very important safety measure. And then the final one, masks optional, where those bottom two levels, that's really where things are, we feel a little bit safer. So you'll see that chart a lot throughout this year, and we hope that's a clear way for us to understand what are the mask requirements in the district. So you know, sending your kid to school, whether or not a mask is required, strongly recommended, or completely optional. I mentioned a moment ago that one of our safety mitigations is shield testing. Shield testing is a saliva-based testing system that all students and our staff can optionally choose to participate in. We'll have a consent form for you and your family to consider this shield testing, and there are a lot of benefits that we think would make this worthy of your consideration. The most important consideration is this testing, which is a very reliable and quick form of testing, will allow you to know if any of your students that go to our district are immediately testing positive. So that would allow you to have protection at your home, other members of your families, and everyone in the classroom will locate this positive test right away. So that's obviously the most important thing, is it obviously slows down the spread within the school and your family. But the second thing to consider in this is one of the things that we're really worried about is people that are deemed close contact to someone that's positive. We call them the close contact. There are a series of quarantines that you'd be eligible to be excluded from school for a period of time. The nice thing about shield testing, and next week you'll get a lot of information for us about this, including the consent form, is that with shield testing, you have the opportunity to test your way basically out of the quarantining process by being masked and being away from people and doing negative tests. You would be able to not have to be deemed a close contact in quarantine if you were doing those things. So the idea is we want to express that you're really in control of a lot of things that would take that worry of your child being quarantined out of the equation entirely, and especially the shield testing, because if you test negative on days 1, 3, 5, and 7 after being deemed a close contact, you would not have to be quarantined. Whereas if you were not participating in the shield program, you would have to be quarantined. So we'll have more information on you next week, and that's a big thing to explain, but we want to make sure that everyone understands where this new system is allowing our students to stay in class and stay in school as much as possible. And that would also include sporting events. We don't want any of our athletes to be excluded for 2 weeks in competitions and practices, and this is another protection for you and your family to keep your child safe. As you might appreciate, there's a lot going on in regarding to the conditions locally and how the guidance from the state and from CDC and the Illinois Department of Health and even our county health department affects our daily decisions of how school will look. But the most important thing is we will be present, and we have a lot of things in place to keep our students as safe as possible. Our goal is to keep everyone there and reduce the opportunities for your student to be quarantined or deemed a close contact so you can stay in school, enjoy the live experience with your teacher, and we can get as close back to normal as you can. Again, if you have any questions or thoughts, we're happy to help. Building principals are the best resource to help you understand the local conditions, and above all, we're excited to get back to school. Thanks, everyone. Appreciate your time.